very, very challenging in some of the community networks, most especially for Bosco, Uganda, that we provide the rural community. Inadequate and costly equipment for upgrading the networks. We have experienced this over years. None of them can change to reduce the cost, but instead, even if technologies are changing, the costs are also changing, gradually going upwards. And that still remains a big challenge. At the end of the day, the cost of repair and maintenance lies ahead of us in the intervention that we have, since these are equipment that has tear and wear and has duration to last. Inadequate transport, these are common things. Funds and resources, resource mobilizations, these are challenges that none of us can say they don't have challenges, but for us as Bosco, we know it's a challenge that we need to work through and then see how best we can work out this. We are also doing some proposal writings. We are also doing some sustainability plan to make sure that we mobilize resources that can sustain these small centers that we're talking about. The policy framework still lies ahead of us. I know most of us have been infringed by this because all these countries that we're working with have different policies, rules and regulations that all the services that we provide needs to undertake. Many of these sometimes bog down the initiative that we have to provide the services to the rural communities. Sometimes we looked at communities and the affordability of the services that we provide to them. We do provide community trainings and provide a solar system that runs the center. But how affordable are those to community that does not have the means to get those kind of services? When you looked at our rural communities, basically, they have subsistence ways of living. Subsistence means of surviving for a day. But how can we support them through community initiative that is affordable and they are able to embrace? When you look up there, those are some of the training that we do for our youth group and then community that have taken up our project. We talk about infrastructure sharing. Some of those are the infrastructure that belongs to Bosco, Uganda. Some of them are infrastructure that we are sharing with some of the radio networks that lives within our region. We normally put our solar panels as a backup for the system to make the community centers run on their own as an alternative ways of putting a generator or a diesel generator to run 24/7, 360 days. But those are very costly. If you are to compare running a diesel generator on putting up a solar panel that you acquire once and you keep maintaining for some years. So for us as Bosco, we have looked at this as one of the best alternative solutions to make a sustainable community network in Uganda. Talking about sustainability, we need to embrace some of those components that many people talk about. We need to have opportunities for public access of our solutions that we are taking to them. Sometimes we take ideas to community, but we don't allow them to take it, to own it. How do we give our community network name that it's a community program but community has not embraced it. This has been a challenge to many community interventions all over the world. People always bring their initiative, throw it there. At the end of the day, community distance themselves and you fail to make it a successful program in the community. Therefore, we need to have community programs that community embrace and take it on. As Bosco, we believe in that because before we take any project to community, we must have to do community inceptions and do an assessment and have a community that is known by the grassroots stakeholders. We have a community, we pick a community that has a name, a group that has a name, a group that has a name in the community, not necessarily coming and landing on anybody and say, we want you to host a community center. But we want you to have a name, we want you to have a structure that community knows that, oh, this is a group. If you come to them, you are able to disseminate information. They are known. Those are the kind of ideas that we take down to the community. And that has helped us in the sustainability of our program. We need to cultivate the competition through policy users, policy implementation. We have that spectrum that lies, which is very difficult to pass through. The hurdles of policies are always the issues. We need to encourage different innovations that are there. We have so many innovative ideas that we sit on, but we don't know how to exploit them. But through networking, we are able to do something and sustain our program. We need to look at the different funding agencies, different resources that lie ahead of us that can be tapped. Not necessarily that we have partners like ISO, we have partners like AFRINI. There are many that we can explore by ourselves. We also have resources that we always sit in on, and sometimes we say, we have run out of resources. I need to talk to my partners. And yet, through our own initiatives, we are able to support the partners and support, and also replicate what the partners have given us to another level. We have many national, local, and international plans that lies within our reach. We need to utilize them. Through the work in the community, we were able to sustain some of the community centers by having a group of youths who embraced our community centers. And in the community centers, we do training. And these trainings on business ideas have helped some of them to change their lives, some of them to have decent businesses, decent ways of living. And these are part of the sustainability that probably we need to look into. The industry and innovations and the infrastructure that are there, we need to use them. But through using those, how are we going to help others who don't have the infrastructure and also sit on the same? As Bosco, we put our backup stations. And these are some of the ideas that our team decided to create. These are backup systems that help add security. Sometimes you put your solar and battery on the tower, and at the end of the day, somebody comes in and says, this opportunity is for me. I don't have light in my house. Why can't I tap this? So we came up with that, and we built a kind of a weapon metallic wardrobe, where our batteries, all the system, the units that helps to run the power apart from the solar panel on the tower. So we are able to use those. Those are some of the innovations that we need to create to make our programs work for the community. When we take programs in our community, we need community to accept. The acceptance of community programs is a big blow. The acceptance of community programs to our stakeholders always a big blow. And at the end of the day, it turns out to be a failure. So we need to do this to make some of the programs work better. I'm almost coming to the last point of my presentations, but I have some of the ideas, the training. These are some of the trainings that we do for the sustainability as an alternative source of power. We build capacity of our community members to know how to do the basic. The basic maintenance of the solar and batteries. These are things that we always use. We buy batteries. Some of us who have cars, some of us who have motorcycles, we have batteries on them. Some of us don't know how to operate, but you ignite your car. At the end of the day, if the batteries goes off, you don't know how to plug it on. And this is what we do with our community groups. We build their capacity, irrespective of male and female, old and young, so long as you belong to that particular group. We train you to know the basic. Because Bosco Uganda will not be coming to your community site every day if you have any failure of the system. You need to have major problem, then Bosco can come in with their technical team to support the community programs. Doing the rural approach to create dialogue. We are doing this because we had a history where Bosco came from. We didn't want to leave the idea of our community who were isolated. We train our community on the different platforms. We train them on this building. We train them on human rights. We train them on different kind of community institutional approach. But all these are based on Bosco's slogan of preserving the culture and connecting the people. We did this slogan because communities were trying to resent the new technology that came amidst them. Because many of them were looking at computer as something that is coming up to take away their pride, take away their traditional way of living. But when we brought up the slogan of preserving culture and connecting people, many people have now embraced it. Community members have learned that these are things that will help them change their life. These are things that help, that has helped them get out of isolation of the 20 years here in the world. I've picked this quote that internet can help us to be better citizens. Access to digital networks entails a responsibility for our neighbors, whom we do not see but we, who is nonetheless real and has a dignity, must be respected. The internet can be used wisely to build a society which is healthy and open to share. This is Pope Francis' communication last year. This is what is all about Bosco Uganda, and that is our infrastructure network coverage in northern Uganda. I've not embedded in some of the new infrastructure that is coming up. Bosco Uganda will be added on to this new existing infrastructure, additional 25 computer centers in the refugee settlement who came from southern Sudan, currently are being hosted in Uganda, in the West Nile region. With support from partners like UNICEF, in the subsequent months, we will be adding our network coverage to about 58 community centers and doing all these platforms. So we believe that with support and ideas that we're getting from the different stakeholders and the different community networks, we are able to reach out to the people who are isolated and lack the information that can make them change their lives. The information that we want them to get are the basic, the missing link in the education system that they have. We want to have content that enrich the community lives, contents that can bring about development of the different communities, irrespective of where you come from, irrespective of your culture. Thank you so much. This is what I have.
Thank you, Johnny.